This is Paul McKenna for PT Boxing Association with EsNews. With me, ZELFA BARRETT. How are you, mate? Okay?
Good. How are you, man?
Good, mate. Good. Down here at Gallagher's gym today. It's like your second home.
No, I love it. I love coming here. I love the lads. I love everything about the gym. There's no, like, when you see people come and spar, they're all serious. I enjoy it.
Yeah.
It's not, when you've got a plan in sparring, it's enjoyable. Sparring is not serious. People think, oh, it's all serious. To me, because I prepared my mind, I just love it. I enjoy sparring here. I just enjoy everything to do with it. I enjoy it.
Yeah, that's it. It's good stuff. They're all good lads here. It's just a laugh, innit? It's like being with a group of your mates as well, as training. So it's a good atmosphere and good sparring as well. Obviously, you've been sparring with Quigg today. I know you're very, very good friends with Scott, and obviously former world champion and hoping to be a two-time world champion, Scott himself. So some quality sparring down here.
Yep.
It's good stuff. 13-0 now. Last out, what was it, last month? No, month before last?
Month before last.
Down in Manchester itself?
Yeah, the Bolton did that.
As I say, 13-0 now. Are you not going to be out again?
Yeah,
we've
got a fight December 17th.
Okay.
In Newcastle, my uncle's show.
Yeah.
And then busy year.
That's it.
2017's a busy year, man.
That's it. Obviously, hoping to be 14 by the end of the year and then really push on in 2017.
Busy year, whoever it is, whatever it is, is what it is, you know what I mean? And you don't call no one out. When you win, you just get put in the places to be put in, you know what I mean?
You get
all fighters calling each other out and stuff. No point calling you. You do your talking in the ring. Yeah. You're going to fight someone cool. You're going to fight.
Yeah, but your talent will show for itself. If you keep doing what you're doing, then the fight will come regardless.
I remember my uncle was telling me the cream rises to the top.
Yeah.
So you just keep doing what you're doing. Keep disciplined, dedicated. It's going to come.
Yeah. That's it. And you do live the life.
Of course.
You're like a monk.
It's enjoyable, though. Like, knowing you see the progress and, like, if my uncle told me, keep doing what you're doing and you can become a millionaire, why not do it? You know, in my mind, it makes sense to me. What if I keep disciplined, dedicated, living a life, staying in the gym, being the last one to come out of the gym, I can become a millionaire. Do something you love doing, right? But I don't see why it's not motivational to do that, you know what I mean?
Yeah, of course. It's that's exactly what you say. You know, if the cream rise to the top and you're very highly regarded, you know, a lot of people do speak good things about you, and obviously time will tell, and I'm sure we'll see you can stamp him off in that super featherweight division.
Yeah, of course. That's my aim. My aim too, like, I'm starting to get a bit recognised now, and in all fairness, and like, I'm not even really come out of like second gear. I've just been in first gear still, you know what I mean? People have not seen what I do proper. I've not been into Trench Town where the reflex is showing. I'm only beating you in front of me.
Yeah.
And that's not down to me. People might say it's a bum him. I'm just beating you there. I can't do nothing else.
Of course you can't do any more than
if
that.
If I'm putting them away, then I'm putting them away. And that's not being arrogant or cocky. It's just me doing what I do in training. So I just know that people have not seen me yet. They've only seen like 20%. They've not seen the full package.
So considering they're already impressed with the 20%, what more to come is going
to... When people see the real me, hopefully they will like it, you know what I mean? They like it now, so when they see it proper...
Do you think it's going to be one of them ones where the better opponent you face, the better Zelfa performs on the night?
I remember I was getting my hands wrapped, and the guy was like, well, Chris Adaway's coming to knock you out. He said he's going to knock you out. I looked at him like, all right. No disrespect to Chris Adaway, proper nice sound guy, but he just turned me on even more. I thought, you're going to knock me out. So my attitude in that fight, my attitude like that anyway, but it just brought an extra...
That extra little...
It got me mad deep down so far. That's why that knockout was just devastating the way... And that's why I know you have to win fights, you have to throw punches.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I believe in this.
Yeah.
I don't rely on my speed, my power, I rely on this. This controls everything.
Yeah.
So the better the opponent, the more of the fear factor, the more they have to throw, you know what I mean?
The
higher the level, the higher you go. But great fighters can also keep that level when they fight someone low, you know what I mean? So it's a bit like this, I just believe in me.
Yeah. Obviously, being on a few of the bigger shows, and then obviously your fight on not smaller shows, no disrespect to Pat shows and all, but being on a few of the smaller shows and all. But it doesn't really faze you regardless, does it, being on either show? You just get in there and do what you do.
A ring in the, I don't, it can be in the car park, it can be anywhere. I'm focused. Them little shows bring you on, believe it or not, because you can make mistakes in them little shows, not many people will see them. But you can't really make mistakes in the big showcase.
Under the big
everyone
lights,
watching
yeah.
you then, and everyone be like, oh, that's a blue penalty to beat him.
Them
little shows, they're where you can make mistakes,
yeah.
where you can go over stuff. But these big shows, this is where a lot of young fighters, they get mixed up. Oh, I'll be signed straight away. And then in the third and fourth fight, they show mistakes. And then, all right, that's a blueprint how to beat him. We'll work on this. You know what I mean? So
rather than being behind the scenes.
Being behind the scenes
up.
In training, you make a lot of mistakes in training. I'd rather make a mistake on a small horse show and then going in a big horse show where it's live on TV. At the moment, I believe that, obviously, you got coaches that'll be like, oh, he does this wrong, does that wrong. But I believe I've not made a mistake yet. Don't get me wrong, everyone makes mistakes, no one's perfect, but I believe that every time I've been on TV live, I've done everything right. And like, they always say, it's different. You can watch someone and be like, oh, I can hit him with this, but when you're in the ring with him, it's a different.
Of course.
You know what I mean? Like, when you watch Crawler and you look at him, you think, like, I can have a go with him. When you're in the ring with him, it's a whole different game. You know what I mean? So, but yeah. Them small hall shows, they bring fighters on differently.
That's it. I believe you're a big fan of Crawford. Yeah, like
the
super fan
ever.
Of Crawford.
The best ever. Like,
yeah.
In my mind, we're out of the Mayweather era. You understand? So the Mayweather era, don't get me wrong, no one could touch Mayweather. But now he's gone.
Yeah.
You don't know if he's gone yet.
Yeah.
Now he's just having his break. It's all about Crawford in my eyes, because I don't see no one beating him.
Yeah.
Because he's adaptable to everything. He's like Bruce Lee would say, he's like water. He doesn't form. You want to do something, he'll just change.
Yeah, he does. You can see that in his fights, he can change.
And he stays it. He'll turn southpaw, do you ready? You throw, it'll make, you know what I mean? So, Crawford is my man.
Yeah. Do you take a lot of stuff from watching the likes of himself?
Every day, like, even when I was sparring today, I just practice little things, turning southpaw, you know what I mean? Everything he does is for a purpose.
Yeah.
And he's that naturally, he's probably not even know he's doing it. So, in my eyes, he's the man.
Yeah.
He's the man.
That's it. Had Lyndon here with you today as well. 2-0 now.
Yeah, 2-0. Yeah.
It's good to obviously be training and now on that sort of pro ride with one of your good friends as well, out the same gym.
Yeah,
and it's good stuff.
It's like a ripple effect. When you do good, everyone else does good, you know.
Yeah,
I mean?
Success breeds success.
So like, it's good to have everyone around you doing good. Like our gym, I believe our gym's gonna come back. Like, we had a break, that was all. We didn't go missing. We just had a break. We had to plant our seeds again. Now we're back up there, if you know what I mean? And I believe that our college almost is going to be like it was.
Yeah.
Better. We've got more flavour, we've got more style, you know what I mean?
That's
so
it.
I just believe in the next 2-3 years, we're going to be that gym again. It's coming slowly. And it's not only just going to be me like that. You've got Lyndon, you've got Ryan, you've got other fighters coming through differently.
Yeah.
All different styles, but all good. So I believe that our gym's going to be back on the map.
Yeah, that's it. Cool, mate. Well, listen, best of luck on the December 17th.
Oh,
I'm sure we'll catch up here around that time. And look, if not, we'll catch up definitely with
nice
you next
one.
Year. So
thank
it's
you.
Good stuff, mate. Good luck. And
oh, thank you.
Yeah,
nice one,
mate. Thank
nice
you.
One.